Peace and love, royal family. I wanted to speak to y'all about ascension and relationships. You know, a lot of people nowadays, especially in our community, when I call y'all royal family, you know, it's our nobility, our pride that we share that makes us royal. And when you go into kings and queens and relationship, it's very complicated when it comes to the hierarchy of God, you know, and just the hierarchy of the higher worlds, because when you're in your lower self, you're really not conscious. You just have desires. You're attracted to somebody from either their looks, their ass, their hips, their teeth, their eyes, their nose, you name it, you know, their hands, their feet. It's all types of people out here who have different things, stomach. And these is lower animal traits that's in you. And for you to be able to really sustain a real relationship like a king and a queen, you have to look beyond the material of a person. And you can't just say you're going to look beyond the material, because inside of you is that animal you. That's like, you know, you get with a person and y'all go out to eat and have a nice little romance, which builds up to, you know, some real animal passion in the bedroom. And it's that animal passion that really drives you to do everything else, you know. And that's the part of you that you have to come to terms with, because sometimes we suppress it and we didn't never fulfill it. So it might be dormant in us for years. Even when we get into our mature years or past that stage of where we were supposed to explore that, because the fact we didn't, we still curious, and that curiosity still hold us down like an anchor, and we can't ascend because of that. So you would have to accomplish everything that your desires wanted of the lower self, so you could be satisfied and ascend to your higher self. Now, when you ascend to your higher self, this is a purification process of actually letting yourself dissolve into yourself. Your higher self eat up your lower self by changing your habits, changing your environment, changing the people you're around, and actually changing your mind. You do that by isolating yourself, by you taking the time out, you know, one day out of the week or month or whatever the case may be, saying you're not going to interact with people, no real TV or radio or anything, but start putting in your head your likes and dislikes. If I was you, I'd walk around in just your boxers or your underwears. Look at yourself in the mirror. Are you that person you see yourself in the mirror as? If not, you could change everything, fix everything. If you have habits you wanted to stop, it's the time when you isolate yourself and you meditate on that new you, the way you want to see yourself, the way you want to eat, the way you want to stop habits. And this now becomes like a discipline. You're serious. There's nobody really to talk to, no distractive energy or noises around. And so you could just manifest this into your reality for tomorrow. Say, today is the day I stay in and make sure I'm changing myself. I'm serious. I'm getting into a meditative state. I'm isolated. And when you come out, you keep that same mind state. So when you pass that donut shop, you don't stop and grab a donut. If you pass that smoke shop, you don't grab that cigarette if that's the case. Whatever its pattern you want to break, you just break it. And that's what you're looking for. Not really to stop eating the food or stop doing something. Look for the pattern in you to break that pattern so you can have a new cycle, a bigger cycle. You know, and so that's how the isolation process works and why it's primitive for us to do it. You have to isolate yourself for actual real change that you can see. And so once you do this and you start the isolation process, you will see that you not only become a whole different you, but also you become one with your intuition. This becoming one with your intuition, it gets stronger and stronger until the best way I could put it like this is these medieval peoples and the peoples back in the beginning of AD called it the Holy Spirit come upon them. And this is practice that you get first from using your intuition. And once you pass a certain level of intuition, you become your intuition. So the spirit do ascend upon you now. And when the spirit ascend upon you, it makes you see things different. You don't follow your lower animal self, or you even follow authority. You follow your spirit. You, whatever you feel at the moment is what you do, is what you go with. There's no one to hold you down, and you don't try to hold nobody else down. It's a free spirit world. So when you meet somebody and interact with them, you go and have a nice time. Y'all go eat, whatever. Y'all have beautiful love, romance. But there's no need to try to make a contractual agreement upon staying together or cohabitate just for sexual favors, or to just deny that person their destiny. You got to let everybody complete what they have to do in life and not be so selfish with your thoughts and desires, so that that person could complete what they have to do in their life to do their destiny. It should only be a person taken away for a while, not taken away forever. Or a person should not believe that they are spared from or exempted from their virtues or what they have to do in life because they met somebody or they made kids. Regardless if you made kids or whatever, you still have to do. Remember this. Taking care of kids, loving your family, and doing for your family is not considered a higher being trait. That's a low animal trait. An animal do that with his. You got to look at the animal kingdom and compare yourself to the animal kingdom and see what's the difference. So in it, you will learn to ascend and look beyond these things and teach them lessons. Lessons always hurt, because truth hurts. That's why they made up that term, the truth hurts. And if you don't speak the truth, you're condoning all the stuff that is going on in this world, all the misteachings and miseducation that we have got. Even you might know better, but you're not speaking up on it, or you condoling it or participating in it. It's the same thing as you might as well say you're the slave master or you're the one doing it. You know, our thing is to make change, it takes pressure. Pressure busts pipes. Pipes busting make people change. Go change your clothes, you're wet now. You understand? And that's what we have to do. We can't be agreeing with stuff that we disagree with inside. Speak the truth and let it all out. If you don't have to be in a relationship to love somebody. You can love them, make love to them, and still be faithful, but go about your business. Your faithfulness comes from you testing different women or different men and then saying that, okay, this one right here, I'm satisfied with. But if you with somebody all the time and something come along, curiosity is going to kill the cat. You never really gave yourself time to figure out what you really want. It takes some time. I said a relationship don't really start till after a year, year and a half. Between that, you got to really get to know the person, because everybody's portraying an image of themselves or what they see on TV or what's called expectations. Once you look beyond the expectations, because if I live up to your expectations, or you have expectations, to be honest, I'm going to give you what you expect. But that doesn't mean that's who I am. So nobody really know anybody till after a year of being with them. Then you'll notice a relationship, you follow your heart. Your heart is the most deceptive thing that you have on your body. It's its own separate entity. If you don't believe me, or you say, oh, yo, you're being cruel, look at how many relationships you've been in and how many times your heart told you, this is the one, this is the one, this is the one. And guess what? You still engage in these activities of the heart. And even though you know you've been deceived every time, today you're telling yourself, no, this is the one. Get it together. None of them is the one. It's the mind that controls everything. You got to be the mediator of that. And instead of you running into your emotions and feelings, you need to walk into it slowly. Give your heart away. Never. That's never in the equation. But if you're going to do that, take your time. There's no rush to do that. You understand what I'm saying? Well, because once you do it, you can't take it back. Only way it's going to come back is through hurt and pain. With love come hate. It's both of them. Those two is synonymous. It's one. So you got to understand how to use the energy. Don't let the energy use you or the person you're with. If you love that person, it's supposed to be unconditional regardless of who they love. And remember this, don't be the hoe of Babylon. The hoe of Babylon was supposed to have been Egypt. That's what it says it in there. But how it's interpreted is this way. The hoe is the one that has a friend you've been with for a long time. All of a sudden now, a new person come along, and you forget about your old friend just because you fucking them or whatever the case may be. Now that's evil right there, because, and it says a lot about your character too, because that was your friend prior to meeting them. You got more with that person than the new person, but now you act like you don't know that person, you never met them, or you don't, and you even might be like, I dislike them now, all over some pussy. Now you see, I would observe you from the sideline and wouldn't fuck with a person like you, because I see that as a whole. If somebody new come in your life, they gotta accept everybody behind you too. It doesn't matter. You don't have to be like, well, I can't talk to you because I'm fucking with this person. That's some clown shit. When you do that, that person who took you away don't respect you, because they know if you did that with that person, you're going to do that to them. You're going to act like you don't know them soon, and when the next person that suits your favor come along. So you got to understand, people is observing and watching, and not everybody is on the lower level vibrations all the time. They see things that other people can't see within themselves, and they could foresee the future of events that's going to happen within a situation or a relationship. So I just wanted to put y'all on that. You know, it's getting dark now. University of Conscious Science. One love.